Hello, my name is Vincent Dinculescu, and I'm a final year resident at the University of Calgary. Today I'll be presenting a case of diffuse idiopathic pulmonary neuroendocrine cell hyperplasia with carcinoid tumor. The clinical history of this patient is a 62-year-old female who initially presented with cough and fever. An outpatient chest radiograph demonstrated an ill-defined nodule within the mid-left lung. A chest CT was obtained 1 month later. At that time, the infectious symptoms had resolved, and the patient complained of occasional dry cough, congestion, without shortness of breath or weight loss. The relevant medical history for this patient is that she is an ex-smoker with a 30-pack year history. Here we have unenhanced axial CT images through the chest, which demonstrate a background of mosaic attenuation related to air trapping, demarcated by the blue circle here. Additionally, there is mild bronchiectasis with nodular bronchial wall thickening, highlighted by the blue box here. A left lingular lesion, demarcated by the green arrow, is also demonstrated with a background of small scattered pulmonary nodules, demarcated by the red arrow. Here we have axial SPECT and fused SPECT CT imaging of the chest, obtained 24 hours after the IV administration of 111 indium-labeled octreotide, which demonstrates uptake within the nodule and the lingula, shown here on the unfused and here on the fused images. The final diagnosis in this case is diffuse idiopathic neuroendocrine cell hyperplasia with carcinoid tumor. In terms of imaging findings, this usually presents with multifocal bilateral pulmonary nodules, bronchiectasis with bronchial nodular thickening, mosaic pulmonary attenuation, and in this case, the nuclear medicine imaging showing octreotide uptake within the left lung lesion seals the diagnosis of carcinoid tumor with dipneck. There are a number of differential diagnoses which could have been considered in this case. Things such as pulmonary metastasis could have been considered, however, the lack of a primary malignancy and the presence of mosaic attenuation would make this less likely. Given the history of smoking, respiratory bronchiolitis could have also been considered. However, this should demonstrate an upper-low predominant pattern with more centrolobular ground glass nodules, which are not present. Follicular bronchiolitis could have also been considered. However, this should have demonstrated a lower-low predominant pattern with centrolobular nodularity and scattered cysts, which are not present in this case. Additional diagnostic considerations in this case include sarcoidosis. This, however, should have demonstrated a perilymphatic distribution of the nodules, which is not present here. Diffuse pulmonary meningioendotheliomatosis could have also been considered, however, this would present with diffuse micronodules throughout the lungs, and these nodules are usually asymptomatic. Additionally, infectious or aspiration-related bronchiolitis could have been considered, however, this should demonstrate some tree and bud nodularity, which is not present in this case. For take-home messages, diffuse idiopathic pulmonary neuroendocrine cell hyperplasia, or dipneck, is a rare disease characterized by the proliferation of neuroendocrine cells within the bronchial walls. Findings include multifocal micronodules, or nodules which can be ground glass or solid in attenuation, with a centrolobular distribution. Bronchial changes include eccentric thickening or nodular thickening. Nodules greater than 5 mm are classified as carcinoid tumors. Patients are usually managed conservatively with a good prognosis, having a 5-year survival rate of approximately 83%. Long-term follow-up is recommended to exclude nodule growth and development of carcinoid tumors and/or lymph node metastases. Coexistent carcinoid tumors are treated with excision. Thank you for taking the time to view this case.